Hiya, my name is Elizabeth. I'm a medical student and an artist living in London, and I'm sharing my top tips for taking notes with active recall in medical school. Number one, what to take notes of. I try to keep my note-taking to a minimum. This is because it's just more likely that I'll actually use them for revision and not hate myself later if the notes on my lecture are quite short. The things that I will capture are things that lecturers explicitly say are very, very important, things that I've gotten wrong in previous exams, or things that come up again and again and I just don't seem to be able to remember, or for me, anything clinical. This will immediately go into my notes. So, how do I actually capture notes? Sometimes I will screenshot from the presentation. I would strongly advise that if you ever do this, you create a one-line short summary of the main thing that you want to learn from the slide. Very often, slides are overcrowded, there's too much information on them, and you're just going to hate yourself later. I will always make a short summary of what I think is the main thing to take away or the reason that I thought that this was relevant to go in my notes. If a lecturer is saying something, I will also take that down and summarize it in as little words as possible. Now, active recall. So, active recall is basically a way for my future self to try to remember something rather than just passively reread it. So, what I do is, if I've captured something from the lecture, I will immediately turn this into a question. This is while the lecture is going on. So, for example, if the lecturer said that there is a difference between veins and arteries, this is that arteries have a more developed tunica media. So, I will immediately turn this into a question: what is the difference between veins and arteries? And I will write this right above that note. I will do this for basically everything. So, all the information that I capture, I might turn into a question. This is super easy to do. You can't just write what is X or Y, what is the difference between Y and Z, what is the reason that we need to know this, what is the risk of that, and this is how I approach it in medicine. I'm just going to add that I use Notion to take my notes, and the reason for this is that Notion has such a cool toggle function, and you can just paste the answer underneath and the question at the top, and you can hide and show the answer as you wish. So once I'm done with my lecture, I'll just hide everything, and then when I'm revising for my exam, I can open and close these answers. So Notion is absolutely incredible. If you're looking to switch up your note-taking system, I would definitely, definitely recommend it, but I'm sure that you can create similar things on other platforms. My notes have two main parts. One is the active recall questions, and the second part is the summary. So I think that the summary is incredibly important. It will usually, for me, be one or two lines where I just write the whole point of the lecture, or at least what the point of the lecture is to me. So what my main learning things for the lecture may be. I would strongly recommend this because by exam time, you will literally have hundreds of lectures. You won't have time to go through the whole thing. So you can either look at these one, two points and think, oh, you know, I know that well enough, or oh, I definitely need to restudy this, rather than having to go through the whole thing again or not having a clue by just looking at the title. And in the summary, to make things even easier for myself, I will use underlining and highlighting and bolding just to draw my eyes to the most important parts. I'm all about forcing my attention to the right things because I don't have a lot of it. My next tip is to search for things on the spot. If a lecturer says something that I don't remember or I don't know, in this case for me, it was VEGF, which I'd completely forgotten what that was, I will not go through the whole rest of the lecture not understanding what they're discussing, but I will immediately search for it. I use Alfred, which makes this function so much easier, but you can obviously go without. And I would just look at something. Obviously, I'll put this in my questions because I don't know what it is. So I'll make an active recall question, I'll copy paste from Google what the answer to it is, and I'll continue with my lecture. In this way, once the lecture is wrapped up, I know exactly what's going on. My next point is to utilize empty time. If there's a time in a lecture where they're talking about something that I'm quite comfortable with, for example, in this case, it was cellulitis and edema, which are two topics that I've covered fairly thoroughly myself, this part of the lecture was a lot less relevant to me. So I used this time to kind of search the things that I was was less confident on or things that I didn't know and add to my notes. My last point is to create Anki flashcards on the spot. It's very easy if you're using any sort of computer to copy paste things across different apps. So I will take something from Notion, drop it into Anki, create a close for it, and yep, I've created a flashcard immediately. By using all these methods, once the lecture is done, I am completely done with my notes. I have a solid summary, I have some solid questions to go through in preparation for the exam, and because I've Googled everything that I haven't understood, I've got nothing that I don't understand anymore. In the end of the day, I think that the world has been going round before active recall, before lecture note taking, and definitely before my video. So none of these things are absolutely essential. I just think that they definitely have helped me a lot. So hopefully you might find integrating any one of these points, if any at all, into your workflow might help you be more efficient in the ways that you study. I'm always very, very open and keen on learning new study methods. So if you have any ideas on how I can improve mine or something that works for you, please, please let me know. Thank you so, so much. Be kind to yourself and others, and don't believe everything you think. Thanks. Bye.